I'd like to take a moment to talk about young horses and what they call baby teeth or deciduous teeth or caps. The word deciduous means that they fall off and are replaced with a permanent tooth, just like a deciduous tree loses its leaves in the autumn and gets a new leaf in the spring. The reason why we horsemen call them caps is because the baby tooth sits on top of the permanent tooth like a cap on top of your head. So as the permanent tooth comes up and erupts, the cap falls off. And this is a natural process. Those who have never had a young horse will call me up and say, somebody kick my horse because these two front teeth are broken. And I always ask, well, is the horse about 2.5, 3 years of age? And they say, yeah, how did you know? And then I explain to them that this is a natural process of the horse losing its teeth. So these two and these two, the first central incisors come off first, followed by the middle incisors, followed by the corner incisors. And all 12 of these teeth are replaced by 4, 4.5 years of age. But what we often don't see is, of the 6 cheek teeth on the upper side and lower side on each side, the first 3 are deciduous, and that's why they're called premolars. And those deciduous teeth come off at about 2.5, 3.5, 4, 4.5 years of age, depending on the breed and where you're located. So there's 3, 6, 9, 12 more teeth coming out on the cheek area. So when we're working with young horses that are under 5, we're always looking for these caps to see if they need to come out or not. The reason we try to take them out ourselves is if your horse is in training at that point and trying to perform, this cap can sometimes fall halfway off and dig into the cheek or into the tongue and cause performance problems as well as pain and chewing problems in the horse. So if we can get those teeth out of there before they erupt, naturally, it actually helps the horse. Think of the expression full mouth by 5. So if you have a horse that's 5 years old, most of all, or if not all the cheek, the deciduous teeth are gone, the caps. On occasion, the corner incisors hang on and they don't go. If the tooth isn't coming up directly, but it's coming up to the side, it will sometimes won't displace the cap, and that cap has to be physically removed, especially if it has a long tail or what I call, tail or tag that keeps it in place. That brings me to another subject. If a horse's tooth is coming up and erupts, but it has a really long tag here, sometimes it erupts and leaves that tag, that little thing. I call it a cap remnant. And these cap remnants are much like a kernel of popcorn or some other food that you might eat that gets stuck between your gum and your tooth. And it becomes a focus of attention, and the tongue is constantly in there trying to get it out. It also causes a break between the tooth and the gum line, so debris can get in there and cause a local infection that they call a periopocket. And you have to wait until it comes out. Now, these cap remnants usually can easily be found as you palpate and your finger comes across them. You can feel them, and we just come in there with a pick and leverage it out and remove it. But on occasion, these remnants don't show up till the horse is well into its teens. And we've seen horses as old as 16 suddenly pop out a cap remnant. It surprises the heck out of us, but it's there and we take them out. And oftentimes these horses don't even know it's a bother. But for many horses, it becomes a focus of attention, these cap remnants. And the horse could be 5 or 6 or 7, and these cap remnants are still there. So you always have to be looking for them. The best way to look for them is actually feel for them with your fingertips along the gum line, both the inside and outside of the first 3 cheek teeth, and you remove these cap remnants.